It's on Collectible Fans. This is Fly Guy. We're looking at another Ant-Man Marvel Legends figure. This time it is Marvel's Bulldozer, aka Henry Camp. So we'll look more at this figure in just a second. Let's get a quick look at the packaging, if I can work the focus properly. There is the Build-A-Figure Ultron logo. It's part of the Ant-Man wave. And there is the Ant-Man movie logo there. Not much else on the front of the packaging. Pretty straightforward. And in the background of the packaging, just to see, there's little kind of ant-like drawings in the inside. And the logo there, Marvel's Bulldozer. The usual yada yada on the bottom. And in the back, there's all the figures in the wave and all of the parts which make Ultron. Marvel's Bulldozer comes with part number 3. We'll review Ultron at the very end rather than review just an arm and a leg. We'll show you the full figure. There's the rest of Henry there. He's part of the very famous Wrecking Crew. And this is one of the figures that people have been waiting a long, long time for. But great to finally get him out. And he's a solid figure. Definitely one of the better ones in this wave. Let's get a look at him. So, pretty solid figure. One of these oversized figures that come in the Wrecking Crew size. Such as Wrecker and the others. But first thing that hits you on this figure, beautifully done, sculpted and kind of molded into the figure, is this gigantic kind of frame on his head, this metallic piece, and it's just pitted and worn and scratched and scored. This is the thing that confuses me, is we can get great stuff like this on Marvel Legends, and then just zero texture, zero weathering on the rest of the figure. So it's a real shame they do that. But look, it's down to costs and logistics. There are other factors at play, but not a fan that his helmet is not removable. It does make for a very odd looking figure that you can see his sculpt of his head has been blended all in one. So it looks a little odd from the sides. It's fine from straight on, but yeah, it does look a little strange the way it just goes right up to the front of that helmet there. But very nice. Almost kind of Thrasher Batman-like metallic look on it. Just love it. All the little pits and scratches and scores, they are beautiful. Really, really like that. And of course, his body underneath is a genetic body. It's been used several times before. Can't recall off the top of my head which one, but Wrecker, I think, was one of them. But you can see the veins and the arm, and there's some nice sculpting on this mold. Some kind of ripples and creases, and of course, ridiculous abs. And more of these cool little metallic pieces. What we do also get is down at the bottom, again, the same metallic parts and brown boots with a different colour on the figure. And again, that orange is all one solid, no wash, no dry brushing, no nothing, but a bit of a shame. But it's a good looking figure, it does look good. He kind of dwarfs the other figures just a little bit, but pretty solid overall. Now he's got some packing articulation. This head is quite misleading. It looks as if it won't go because of that armor piece there, but it actually goes all the way in, so you get the figure that far forward. That's pretty good considering all that armor's there on that head. It will also, if you pull it back a little bit, get the figure up as high as that. So that's pretty stonking. So you can see the ball joint on that little peg there. It's pretty well done. So there's plenty of movement, and Hasbro's designers, well done designers, have left a really good plenty of room and movement on that figure should you want to pose him in that way. So plenty of articulation on the head. You can see up at the top of the arms there, they're on a ball joint. You can see the pegs up there, so plenty of movement on them. Also, you get swivel biceps, rocking. You also get single joints at the elbow, which is common for a figure this size. You also get swivel gauntlets, and that's it in terms of articulation on the arms or the hands. There's no other back and forth. It's just that swivel, and that is you. Ab crunch is happening. You can hear that little click almost going on. And there is a swivel waist there, just down below the belt, as you can see. Up at the top, we've got that peg yet again, or the ball joint, I should say, in this time. So that allows that to be pretty damn flexible. And also, we've got swivel thighs, double joints at the knees, so plenty of good poses. And just like the wrists, they've got, well, they're not, they're different, my apologies. There is no articulation down the top of the boot, but you do get rocking ankles and articulated toes, which again is pretty common for a figure this size. So that's pretty good. Very impressed with that. And of course, peg holes, same as on the other figure. So not bad. Not bad at all. It's a pretty good looking figure. Do like it. Love the metallic aspects. That is definitely a huge factor in this. He will be one that will sell it quicker than others. That is for sure. Again, a lot of people were just looking to get him for the Wrecking Crew. But love to know your thoughts. What do you think of the Ant-Man movie? What's the best Ant-Man comic? I have not read a single Ant-Man comic. Shocking, I know, but I don't know a good story arc. please let me know. Let me know what you think. I've read him in the Avengers with Wasp and so forth, but not a standalone Ant-Man comic as yet, so we'll have to get into that. But I'd love to hear your thoughts and comments. Keep the conversation going below. Again, I'm sure you know the drill, but if you're not, if you're brand new to the channel and you're just joining us here, we do Marvel and Star Wars reviews and other podcasts. Just click subscribe. There's a link somewhere around there to basically pick this up. Darkseid Toys will have some of these Ant-Man Marvel Legends in, but it's going to be very limited. If you haven't pre-ordered, we'll put a couple of links below to try and get this stuff, because, again, these things are hitting some stores, but taking a little bit longer to get to e-tails. So, yeah, hang in there. They will be coming. That's it. We'll see you for another video coming up soon.